What is good, guys? We are back with OLT Round 3 Losers Bracket Game 2 between Ojama and Solwent. Game 1 was my latest upload, so you guys can check that out. It was quite long, so I decided to split this series. If they bring the Mega Heracross team, then it's either Scarf Victini or Scarf Chomp. I assume the other one of the two is the Z-move user, then this could be Defog. This is probably 3 attacks. Roost Zapdos. Solvers Midjourner, he's pretty weak to opposing Midjourner. And Solwent has just Volturn and do Mega Mawile. I assume this is AV as well. This is either Specs or Physical, that's like the only sets that you see at the moment. And then this is probably Scarf. I don't know if this is probably not Ash. Probably Ash, and then the defensive land with Rocks because he's pretty weak to Zygarde. So someone is probably gonna scout for the Choice Scarf Victini here. Ojama stays in, that makes me think that he's Choice Scarf and he gets a crit. That sucks a lot because the crit cancels out the Intimidate. I think that would have done around maybe 35%, maybe a little bit more. And then Solwent could have gotten up Rocks to pressure the Victini and the Zapdos and force the German to default, but this is annoying. For Solwent, he's obviously going to keep this as a sack fodder. He can go into one of these two mons here. They both resist V-Create. So Ojama could double into Midjourner because that covers those two. Yeah, it's pretty obvious to me that Ojama's not gonna stay in because he knows that someone is gonna keep this as fodder. Solwent couldn't predict that. Ojama switching out and go for Roxy. That would be a good play from Solwent, not gonna lie. He goes out into Zapdos, not sure what he predicted there. And also, Solwent made like a risky play there going Tapu Koko, so he was most likely predicting Ojama to not stay in. So he is most likely spec since he goes for Volt Switch. And Ojama makes a godly play in the guard from there. Ojama can get up his rocks here. I'm not 100% sure what he predicted going to Koko. Because if you predict the Midjourner that covers those two mons, Koko doesn't really beat Midjourner because the Midjourner's AV. So he goes, instead of defogging, goes in the Mawile there. Again, not sure what he was predicting there. Because this doesn't do much to Midjourner unless it has Fire Fang. Like, see, Playoff doesn't do much, he just gets a Volt Switch here. And now he gets to bring in Heracross. I'm pretty sure Close Combat kills from this range. And then Solwent is probably gonna sack off his Landorus because he dies to Rocks. Since Solwent's Lando got crit and now Rocks up, he's never getting Rocks up because Lando's his only potential rocker, unless Mawile is Rocks. Okay, it's not his only potential rocker, but it's most likely the rocker on his team. I assume the Mawile is just the player set with Sucker Punch, Thunder Punch, and SD. So that's just CC. If he had SD or Sub, there would have been potential plays there. And I assume he's gonna go into Specs Koko to threaten out the Heracross. I'm pretty sure a Dazzling Gleam should be able to pick up a Heracross. So Ojama could go into the Assault with Midjourner here, anticipating a Dazzling Gleam. But yeah, someone can also predict that and just go for like Volt Switch. But yeah, this is already a tough game for Solwent. Like, his Ladi is not gonna do much this game because there's a Midjourner and a Feeny. Let me think. Yeah, like, Ojama's Midjourner is a bit weakened already, so if he goes into Midjourner here on a Thunderbolt, he might get 2-hit killed. So Thunderbolt is a potential play here because I don't think Ojama is gonna go into Garchomp on a potential Dazzling Gleam. The Dazzling Gleam is quite obvious since the Hera is just in front of Solwent, and like, the Hera is a threat to his team somewhat. Yeah, like, the only thing that can Oko the Heracross is like the Mawile, and the Mawile is slow and dies to the Hera, so he obviously cannot go to that. I guess like the Midjourner can obviously Oko it as well, but then he would have to take a fat Close Combat to the face. And some Midjourners even don't run Floor Cannon on AV, but most of them do. So yeah, you can see Fugaz talking about Mega Hera versus Flame Orb Heracross. If you guys are interested in that, you can read the chat, but I'm gonna try to concentrate on the battle. I think he's talking about Facade Heracross can break Clefable with SD or something like that. Okay, he didn't talk about... Yeah, it actually kills Clef. He goes in the Midjourner. Does he make the good T-Bolt play? Okay. T-Bolt would have been fire there, catching the Midjourner. I mean, Solwent was... Dazzling Gleam was fine. But Ojama's really getting all these plays correct. He's playing like God. He can freely Volt Switch around since Solwent's ground type is dead now. Solwent might anticipate Ojama to stay in and go for Dazzling Gleam again to like chip at the Midjourner, and then Coco doesn't take too much if Ojama just goes for Volt Switch. But I think he's gonna Volt Switch because Solwent has his own Midjourner. If he goes for Flurkin into the opposing Midjourner, then he's like kind of in a bad position. But Ojama doesn't lose much from that. I mean, his Midjourner got chipped down, which means that's one of his Lati, and his Greninja, like his Greninja's Lati checks are getting whittled. Oh god, so he makes a risky play there. I assume he predicted Solwent to switch into Lati, and he goes for U-turn, and Solwent makes stays in again, anticipating another voltage. So it's funny how this Coco is just spamming Dazzling Gleam versus the Midjourner, and the Midjourner is only using Volt Switch, so the Coco is like chipping at the Midjourner. The Midjourner is almost dead right now. So now Ojama's like, nah, okay, I'm not U-turning again, I'm a Bolt Strike. It's Electric Terrain boosted, it's gonna do a good chunk to whatever you wanna switch out into. And if you stay in, I'll finally get rid of your Coco. So Sucker Punch does a good chunk, but Solwent is in the back. I feel like Solwent has to play aggressive at this point, and he has to go for Play Rough here. Actually not sure if, I don't think Sucker Punch kills from full. So like, to be fair, Ojama doesn't lose anything from staying in if Sucker Punch doesn't kill from full. I didn't run the Kalk, but I assume from full, Victini's quite bulky. I think it has 100 base stats across the board, so it should be able to take a Sucker. I assume it does like 80%. So knowing that, I guess Ojama didn't lose anything from staying in. He does make the aggressive play rough play, and it pays off for Solwent. He picks off the, even though that didn't really matter because his mower probably outsped the mag. AV mag doesn't really run speed. Some AV mags only run 6 speed AVs to get slow Volt Switches versus Celesteela. I've actually faced that the other day, and I was thrown off guard. So yeah, Close Combo was pretty free there. He didn't really have any reason to predict. Ojama's like kind of in, like he's in a good position, so there's like no point in like going for like an unnecessary pin missile and risk Solwent like staying in. So Psyshock is quite obvious here. I assume Ojama's gonna go into either the Feeny or the Zapdos here. He goes into Zapdos, he should be able to take a Psyshock with ease, but he makes a nice play that goes for Trick. So he's trying to, he's kicking Defog here, but like, his Lati's almost dead because he's obviously Trick Defog double stab, so he doesn't have Roost on this. NJP, I think, runs sometimes Trick plus Roost on his Lati, but then I think he runs it instead of Defog. So since he already showed Defog, we know that it won't be Roost. And yeah, the Zapdos is a big pain for Solwent. Even though it's choice locked now, it's still pretty annoying to him. And he goes in the Feeny there. Since this has lefties and this has lefties, he cannot cripple this with another trick. Jama's most likely gonna go to Midjourner here. Did I say Jama? Solwent is most likely gonna go to Midjourner here. Did he match his Natness? He just goes for Surf. Yo, I don't really see Surf on Feeny that often. It helps with Alolan Marowak versus Lando, but you don't really see Alolan Marowak that often at the moment. So that was a cool play by Ojama. He's getting all these plays correct. He can just go for V-Create here, like, okay, goes for U-turn. Okay, that was a fine play as well, but I don't think he lost anything from V-Creating. And now he can go on a Heracross again and pretty much pick up a kill. I don't remember how healthy the Midjourner is. Maybe the Midjourner can take one. Yeah, the Midjourner can probably take a CC and kill this Hero with a Flurkin. So Ojama goes into Hera into Garchomp on the Volt Switch here, he's a god, but he doesn't have to make that play. Victini can take any hit from this Midjourner, so he can probably just go back to that. He can also just stay in with CC and weaken this. Then come in with Garchomp after, click Earthquake and collect his kill. Like, Guard looks like Scarf Jump is gonna clean up this game. Oh, it's not Scarf Jump, what am I saying? It's Scarf Victini. But yeah, Scarf Victini also kinda cleans up. He obviously has to switch out on a Sucker Punch here, so I would go for Play Rough again. If I was Solwent, like, he's still super far in the back. So, I mean, if he goes for Play Rough here, that would be super nice, but he doesn't, okay? So the Zapdos can just go for Discharge here. Midjourner obviously takes it with ease, but Midjourner is gonna get put in range from Close Combat from Heracross. So Heracross gets a kill the next time it comes in on the Mawile or on the Midjourner. He goes in the Grand and doubles out. Maybe he was Ash Gunner, he got walled by the Feeny. That's probably why he doubled out. So, yeah, he had to double out there because he's in the back, but he cannot win this anymore. Oh, Jama is too far ahead, so Jama's gonna take this game. He gets a para there, but at this point he has the game anyway. And we're gonna get a game 3. That's gonna be a separate video again, because like, I already decided to split the series since game 1 was so long. So even though this game was quite short, or like it's almost over, it's still gonna, game 3 is still gonna be in the next video. It's gonna be an extra video. I also love making thumbnails, so like, it's quite cool for me to like have to be able to put different mons in the thumbnail for each game, because if I have a best of 3 and then I can only put one or two mons for every player in the thumbnail, it's quite annoying. So now he's gonna go Greninja. Jama can just go hard Feeny, or he can also just stay in. It doesn't really matter. Yeah, Hera probably would have died, but after that he could have just gone Feeny and then Moonblasted or Surfed or whatever he would have won. I assume he has Moonblast and Surf, and maybe he doesn't have Nature's Madness. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Ojama takes game 2. This is best of 3, so I'll be back with game 3, like I said. And yeah, I also recorded one or two Snake games yesterday. Those are gonna be coming, and I'll record a little bit more. But like I said, in game 1, I'm gonna go to sleep early today, so I'll probably miss the OT games. I hope Blunder doesn't play his game. Oh yeah, this will probably go up on Sunday. So when I say up today, I mean Saturday. Yeah, okay. We shall see. I feel like this is a cool series. The hacks at the beginning of this game obviously sucked, but overall I like how Ojama is playing with it, is what I'm trying to say. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you with game 3. And I don't know if someone is gonna bring some stall, semi-stall, or trick room again. We shall see. I'm really interested in that. Goodbye.